Welcome into Harris Football's 2022 NFL Draft Prospect Breakdown presented by Viore. I'm your host, Patrick Murray, and today we're breaking down Penn State wide receiver Jahan Dotson. He's 5'11", 178 pounds, and he ran a 4.43 in the 40-yard dash at the NFL Combine. In Dotson's senior season, 2021, he reeled in 91 balls for 1,182 yards and 12 touchdowns and was named a third-team All-American by the AP. He's a pretty good punt returner too. In 2020, he set Penn State's school record, averaging 24 yards per punt return, including an 81-yard touchdown. And back in high school, Dotson was a three-sport star. Of course, football, played basketball, and ran track. And in track and field, Dotson was an individual state champion in 2016 in the 4x100-meter relay and the long jump. And Dotson was the first individual state champion from his school in 46 years. Three things I like about Dotson: speed, hands, and smooth route running. Let's look at the speed first. He makes the catch, and now watch him go. Hits another gear, and nobody can even touch him. Now the hands, and this is just ridiculous. Look at this. One hand, fully extended, pulls it in, and then on the replay, watch how he squeezes it with that one hand. Great hand strength, and what a play. Dotson going up and taking a ball away from Sean Wade, who is now on the Patriots roster. Nice concentration here to stick with it and reel it in. And I really like this one. Dotson going in between three defenders and snatching the ball away and then winning the fight to hold on to it. Let's look at the route running now. Dotson makes this look really easy. On a double move, watch how smooth he is and how he maintains speed through his breaks, ends up with a touchdown. Similar play here. Dotson is very smooth and quick out of his breaks on the double move, blows past the defender, keeps running through the catch, and finishes the play in the end zone. All right, let's go to the iPad and break down a play for you. This play is from Penn State's game against Auburn in the 2021 season. And I want to show you how Penn State offensive coordinator Mike Yurcich schemed open Jahan Dotson against Auburn's cover three. So let's take a look. Here's Dotson lined up at the top of the screen. And Penn State has basically a two-man route concept going. And this is a variation of a Yankee concept, which you see a lot in the NFL. You have the tight end down at the bottom of the screen flexed out wide. He's going to go right up the seam, basically run a seam route. And then you have Dotson coming across on a deep over route, a deep crosser. And they want to throw the football to Dotson here. So the purpose of the tight end is to remove this defender because Auburn's playing cover three. So Auburn has three deep defenders, each responsible for a third of the field deep. Corner's got a deep third, safety's got the deep middle, this corner's got a deep third outside, and then you have four defenders playing zone underneath. He's got a zone underneath, he does. Four underneath, three deep, cover three. So this tight end is going up the field, up the seam, and he wants to take this corner out of there to create some space right here for Jahan Dotson. Now, one other thing that Penn State needs to do is they need to influence this linebacker because he's going to be dropping into a zone and they want to make sure he doesn't drop deep enough to pick up Dotson. So let's show you how they did that. The Nittany Lions are going to use play action to influence that linebacker. So keep an eye on him. They get the play fake. Linebacker gets sucked up by a couple yards. That's all you need. Just enough to give Dotson some extra space. And then we're looking down here at the tight end and the corner. Tight end is going to remove that corner with his seam route going deep. And then look at this space. You got all this space here for Dotson to work. That's what you're looking for. All you need is a good throw and a good catch. Throw maybe could have been a little bit better, but look at that catch. Jahan Dotson with room to work, going up and getting it. Nice play. I like the scheme to get him open, but players make plays. And Jahan Dotson made a play right there. I love it.
Producer Dave giving a quick shout out to Viore for sponsoring this video. You've heard me talk about them before. They make great activewear that's good for working out or just hanging out. I really like them with their clothing, but maybe you're nervous about ordering something from a website without trying it on. I'm sure you've done it before, but you know, this is cool clothing and maybe it's new to you. They're a great company to work with. They always have free returns. You can print out a prepaid shipping label, put it on the package, send it on back, drop it off at any postal service. So, well, I don't think you have to send it back because you don't like it. Maybe you get two different sizes or something. See what's right for you. I'd like you to go check out, if you're getting ready for spring, the core short and the Sunday shorts. They're both really cool and they're going to be great for the warm weather or for getting out there and getting a little run in as you work out this spring. If you want to check them out, I ask you to go to vioriclothing.com/Harris. You'll get 20% off for using that slash Harris, and you'll let them know that you came from us, which lets Viore know that you appreciate them sponsoring the show. Thank you so much for watching. Let's get back to Patrick.
Thank you, Dave. Now back to Penn State receiver Jahan Dotson. Let's look at another example of Dotson beating zone coverage. That is certainly one of his strengths. Dotson is lined up in the slot at the top of the screen, and Ohio State is playing a three deep, three under fire zone coverage behind a blitz. To the three receiver side, Penn State is running two curl routes and a post. Now watch Dotson as he comes out of his break. He doesn't stop. He continues to work toward the open grass, and then he stops in the middle of the two defenders, giving his quarterback a nice throwing lane and a first down. He understands how to find that void in the zone. Now let's see Dotson against man coverage. He's lined up out wide at the bottom of the screen, running a post against Fayon Hicks. He's a senior who ran a 4.37 in the 40 at his pro day, so he's fast. The key to this play here is Dotson's release. He eats up the space between them, gives a quick fake to the outside, then smoothly transitions into his route stem, beating Hicks to the inside, and continues to separate from him with speed. Unfortunately, though, the throw wasn't very accurate, so it's incomplete. There's a lot to like about Jahan Dotson. He can win at all three levels, short, intermediate, and deep. He can make acrobatic catches and one-handed grabs, can create a ton of yards after the catch with speed and elusiveness. But the main concern for Dotson heading into the NFL is his strength and ability to beat press man coverage, particularly against physical, higher quality corners. Dotson is lined up here as the single receiver on the backside of trips at the top of the screen. Auburn corner Roger McCreary, a projected second round pick, is the guy covering him. Dotson can't shake McCreary. Even with a little hesitation move to try to create some space, McCreary still sticks with him. Same matchup here, McCreary on Dotson, but even with Dotson off the ball in a stack to give him some more room to operate, McCreary is still able to lock him down, sticking with him on a go route. And it gets worse when corners get more physical. Fayon Hicks again here, jamming Dotson up, disrupts his release. And then against Ohio State, he can't get open on a slant against a really physical corner in Cameron Brown. And again here, Brown just completely takes Dotson out of the play with physicality. Because he doesn't have very good play strength, Dotson isn't going to break many tackles after the catch. He's going to have to rely on his speed and athleticism to create yards after the catch. But fortunately, he's pretty good at that. Physical press corners might be an issue, but I still think Dotson can play outside in the NFL thanks to his ability against zone and off-man coverage. And he can be very dangerous in the open field with his speed and elusiveness, and he could contribute as a punt returner too. We have plenty more videos on the way in the Harris Football 2022 NFL Draft Prospect Breakdown Series. Go ahead and subscribe to the Harris Football YouTube channel so you can make sure you get a chance to see all of these videos as they come out. Go ahead and drop us a comment as well below the video. Let us know what you think. Give us your suggestions for any prospects you'd like to see us cover in the series. Thank you for watching, everybody.
Thanks so much for watching. Please, please, please smash that like button, write a comment, tell us who else you'd like to see us review film on, and of course, best of all, please subscribe to our channel and then click that little bell above the subscribe button, and you'll be notified whenever we post a new video.